away, etc. The people he thought were his friends had betrayed him, his family had turned their backs on him. He feels as if God has forsaken him. Every day, walking through torment, through misery, through hell, is another day where his boiling point is reached, until one day, enough becomes enough. And this is Isabel. Isabel, or Izzy, was one of Christopher's only friends out of the entire school. She's the only one who dares talk to him. You see, Izzy has moved up the popularity ladder and has made a new name for herself here at St. Amber's. As you will see, it is now detrimental to her status to be seen even 3 feet from him. Well, enough of me talking. Let's look into the life of Christopher and see what unfolds.
Shouldn't you be with your new friends?
Come on, Christopher, don't be like that.
I don't find it fair, Izzy. Those people aren't your true friends. Let me ask you a question. Who was there when your mother and father got that divorce?
I was.
What about when your father passed away?
I was there. I always was.
I mean, you have to sneak around just to say something. Now, Izzy, I would expect that behavior from everybody else, but to have that coming from you, my friend.
Christopher, I know what you're going through.
No, you don't. Do you know what it's like to be called, I don't know, sissy, faggot, queer, anything like that? Do you know what it's like to have to run home every single day in fear of being jumped? And then have your father chastise you because you can't fight back? Do you know what it's like walking down the hallway and having eyes focused on hearing whispers about you, dealing with that every single day? No, you don't. Now see, you had a chance to create something new for yourself. Now, I don't have the luxury of doing that. I mean, I asked my father to take me out of the school system and put me into a new one, but he said, no, man up, a man's not supposed to quit. So therefore, here I am in this hellhole of school, trapped. Wonder what tomorrow will be. It's my senior year, Izzy. I went through so much from the beginning of elementary school all the way up till now. Remember, during our freshman year, we made that agreement that, you know, by our junior year, you happen to become popular like you, remember? All the ridicule, the torture, being beat up, being made fun of, everything was supposed to stop. Again, it's my senior year, and still, I'm the joke of everything.
Come on. never amount to anything but being somebody's wife. Good. That's right. Get angry. Get mad. You deserve to be. This will not help you in your time of need. You have to help yourself. You know where your father's gun is, right?
Well, yes, I do, but I don't know
yes,
if I can...
just think about it. They hate you. They don't care. And that surely won't help you. Your father's gun is the only way to stop the pain, to stop the embarrassment, to stop the physical and verbal abuse.
Robert Steinhauser,
murdered 10 teachers, 2 students, and 1 policeman, and wounded 10 others at Johann Gutenberg Secondary School. After his murderous rampage, he turned the gun on himself. Why did he do this?
On April 27, 2007, Cho Sung-hai murdered 2 in a dorm, and then 30 others in a school building 2 hours later, wounding 15 others. After murdering 32 people, he turned the gun on himself, bringing the death toll to 33, making this shooting rampage the deadliest in U.S. history. Why did he do this?
Children and teenagers all over the United States that go through because they're black, because they're white, because they're Latino, because they're gay, because they're bi, because they're short, because they're tall, because they're skinny, because they're overweight, because he's friends with him or she's friends with her. There was a line in the Skit that said, people fear when they do not understand, and they hate what they fear. People fear what is not normal. Because they don't understand it, or they're simply afraid to. And because they fear what they do not know, that fear breeds hatred. And hatred breeds hatred. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the equation for something like you just did. Never ever think for one second that it couldn't happen to you. Never think for one second that you are immune from this. It can happen anywhere at any time. How much blood needs to be shed before we wake up and realize what it is that we're doing? How many lives have to be lost and wasted before we wake up and realize that enough is enough? Well, that's a question only you can answer. So in closing, I say again, when will enough be enough?
I've been doing this shit, bitch. Been doing this.